Hi, Carl here from Village Wine and Spirits, and for another edition of Scotch Club. And today we'll be trying these three scotches. First is a Vatted malt, all malt blended whiskey from Clan Denny. And the next is a 13-year-old Cragganmore. It's an independent bottling. It's from the distillery, but bottled by James MacArthur, who's an independent bottler. It's a 13-year-old Cragganmore. And then the last one is a 1993 Scapa, 16-year-old, also bottled by an independent bottler, Gordon and Macphail. So we'll decide which ones we like the best and discuss, compare and contrast, and learn a little about single malts versus vatted malts. Maybe in the short term, maybe 20, 25 years, but when you're talking 50 or 100 years, something's got to change. So
it's just the chemistry's got to change.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
Well, that's really what happens. The alcohol content, all that doesn't get stressed.
No.
The flavors.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
They get smoother, they get
all those compounds just, they fall out, or they combine, or they something happens, and they mature.
I mean, that stuff's made to be carbonated
with something. Yeah. Are you supposed to, you're, like, basically, what they'll do is they'll, you know, they'll take it off the still, and they'll water it back for you to whatever it is, 94 proof, 80 proof, whatever. But these guys basically say, here it is, you do that job.
Yeah, I mean, you should buy it if you get down.
Yeah, depending on how you want to drink it. Yeah.
The interesting thing is that they talk about cost to drink. Scotch is that the only one that I actually could drink that I like was one by Macphail, and it's very nice. Pretty high alcohol content.
So in closing tonight, Scotch Club, we had three very different scotches, and there were some surprises as far as what people liked. The higher proof Speyside, it's 122 proof, with some air, really came around, and people really enjoyed the nuances that the kind of the alcohol as it dissipated brought forth. And as the scotches sat in front of everybody, they really started to enjoy the development of the scotch itself. And actually all three of these developed kind of nicely over the night, and some more vanilla notes kind of came out of the middle one. It softened up later on. It was very focused in the beginning. And the vatted malt, it kind of stayed the same. It didn't change as much as these two did, but it delivered on flavor with a nice soft kind of vanilla finish to it, which was expected, but it really came across as a value scotch that delivered on flavor and quality. So the three scotches showed very well. It did take some time for them to kind of come around, but I'm glad everybody got to experience them and try something new, especially